Right, and we're live. So, just wait until we've got some viewers. We'll go in. Hi guys, welcome to the stream. Just going to be doing a few FOBs. I haven't been able to stream for ages because my internet's been really, really slow, but it's been fixed today, so should hopefully work okay. Just going to start off with a few base development FOBs because I just need to raise it, I think, one or two levels. And then after that I'll take some challenges or requests. If you have any questions at all, just feel free to ask and I'll try and answer them as best as I can. I just wish they'd release the blueprints for the rest of the Grade 9 stuff. I mean, it's been about 2 months since I announced them. We've had the wormhole generator, but not the FOB. You can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss. My PSN name is rspencer198420. When we go back to the main screen, you'll be able to see it. It should pop up on the top right. This is a non-lethal base, by the way, so I'm using the Wu-S plus SV pistol, which kind of makes it stupidly easy. Why I don't do standard commentaries? to be honest, the sort of videos that I do on Metal Gear Solid, I don't really need to do commentaries. That's pretty much why I don't do them. I mean, most of the videos are normally just kind of how you unlock this or a quick review of a weapon, that sort of thing. Hi, guys. And to be honest, my mic doesn't work very well with my laptop either. I always have to mess around with the audio settings load, so it's just a bit of a ball ache. Oh, cheers, mate. Do you guys play FOBs much? My staff, okay. Right, so these are my unit levels. I've still got two platforms to build on my last FOB. Got an intel platform and a combat unit platform. But I'm 115 on combat, 122 on R&D, 113 on base development, 117 support, 112 intel, and 113 medical. The reason why my R&D unit's so high compared to the rest of them is just I just really farmed it for the last couple of weeks to try and get the Brennan review out, which completely wasn't worth it at all. The Brennan's not worth investing in at all. But at the same time, R&D unit is probably going to be the one that you're going to need for pretty much all of the grade 9 stuff, so it is... it is still worth boosting up. Never played FOB. It's a really good mode, to be honest. A lot of people tend to be put off by it. They don't seem to see the point of it or anything, but it will make the game last a hell of a lot longer for you if you do try it out. Yeah, the way I kind of see FOBs is it's like, I don't know if you've ever played an MMO or an RPG or something. FOB is kind of like the end game for this. So once you've done all your main ops and your side ops, then you can go to FOBs, and that's what lets you build your unit levels to stupidly high levels, in which case you can then buy all the high-grade weapons. I don't know, it's one of them things, the more you do, the easier it gets. Not only do you get better at it, but you get better gear, which just makes it loads easier. How much did I spend? What you mean in terms of MB coins? Well, each FOB is like 1,000 MB coins or 1,200 MB coins, so... you're looking like £8 each. So I've spent like £24 on the effort on the actual FOBs themselves. Just going to do one more base development, and then I'll take requests. Like if you want to see a particular platform, or if you want to see me do it with any particular gear or anything, or if you want me to show you how to do anything, just ask. Just so you know, when I'm choosing FOBs, what I always do is I go into security challenge, Oh, thanks, Ahmed. Yeah, so in Security Challenge, you get better rewards, basically, and more often than not, you should find a decent leveled FOB. At the very least, you want one with 28 platforms, which is the number on the right. That, because anything lower than level 40 won't give you S++ soldiers. I love MGO, mate. I've put about 150 hours into it. I'm Ascension 2 on one character and Ascension 1 on the other, or something like that. Nearly Ascension 3 on the first character. Yeah, so this guy's a level 44, so he will give S++ stuff. And he's a sniper platform. Do you know something? I don't get attacked very often at all. And the reason for that is, well, there's two reasons really. If you set your security settings to the maximum, you're only really going to get attacked by high level players. Because only the high level players will be able to get through it. Once you get to the level where you can set your custom mines and custom cameras, you can make it hard for even the high level players as well. But then the other reason is I only do security challenge. So by doing security challenge, you don't open up retaliatory wormholes or appear in people's indirect retaliation list. If you just do the normal FOB missions, then if ever you make a mistake, like you get spotted or you have to destroy mines and drones and stuff like that, you'll not only open up a wormhole for that person, but everybody that supports that person. And that's where you kind of get screwed over on FOBs. But if you stick to the security challenge, you won't appear on any of those lists. The only list that you'll appear on is for people with similar PF grades as you. And most of the time they don't really tend to infiltrate you, I find anyway. I'm in the, I think I'm about 580 in the world or something, and you know, you'd think that all the people around my rank would infiltrate me all the time, but they don't at all. Oh, you'll love it, Sebastian. It's a little bit different from the other Metal Gear Solid games, you know, it's not got as many cutscenes or as much dialogue and stuff, but the actual gameplay is fantastic.
Successfully sneak your way into the heart of the rival PF's FOB, and you can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss.
Going back to what I was saying about security challenge, the one thing that it does put you at risk is it alerts the person who owns the FOB straight away. So if they're online, they'll come and defend it against you. There's tricks around that as well. Like if you're if you're English, like me, for example, then at this time of day, then pretty much every American is asleep, so you can go for people who sound like they've got American IDs, or later on, pretty much every Japanese person will be asleep, you can go for Japanese IDs. And there's loads of little tricks around it. He talks a lot in the tapes, though. It's just a shame that most of the storyline is actually in the tapes. That's the only. That's the only downside to it. I mean, I understand why they did it. I mean, I don't know if you've ever played games like Bioshock. A lot of the story was contained in tapes then, but it was the way that you got those tapes was a lot better than that. In this, you just get a cassette tape at the end of each mission, or you get a few cassette tapes at the end of the mission. And yeah, it appears in your inventory, but then you have to go in and manually replay it. But on Bioshock, what happened was you have to actually pick up the tapes that are like dotted around in the levels, and then as you pick them up, they kind of play automatically, or you can go into the inventory and play them manually. Right, so when you're doing sniper platforms, you don't want to do what I did, of course, but it basically means that every sniper will then start looking down their sights and they can spot you really easily as soon as you move. So I'll drop this alert and I'll try and get it to the end. Should be able to do it still. If you do trigger an alert, it's just a case of going somewhere like this. I mean, my favourite spot is under the bridge, but I wouldn't have been able to make it to the bridge from where I was. And then just wait for the alert to drop, and then try and work your way around the back. I mean, they'll all kind of be facing the way you were the last time you were spotted. So you just wait for the alert to drop, and then try and work your way around the back. I'm using the AM MRS 71 grade 7. It's pretty good. I've got a sleep grenade attached to it as well. I wish it had co-op. I don't know if you've ever played Peace Walker. Peace Walker is actually very similar to the Phantom Pain. The way that the missions are structured, anyway, with all the side ops and the main ops and that. And Peace Walker had really good co-op. And what that allowed was, after you'd finished the game, the side op, you unlock loads and loads of side ops, and they were really tough as well, like virtually impossible. So then it encouraged you to play with other people. ever you do a an FOB where someone's got a 99 security team level or higher, you only get 10 minutes to do it. If you cause an alert, then it makes it pretty tough. You kind of only get one chance to make a mistake on a level 99 security one. Yeah, you get better rewards from security challenge. That's the main reason why I do it. You get slightly more staff and resources than you would do doing the normal one. And you don't run the risk of opening up wormholes. So, yeah, for me, it's definitely better to do them. I never use the normal tabs or indirect retaliation tabs anymore. I mean, before they did security challenge, I pretty much only used indirect retaliation. And to be fair, I kind of think indirect retaliation tabs are a little bit broken, because as soon as, like, say someone invades your friend and they open up a wormhole, they'll appear on your indirect retaliation tab. And you can go and then infiltrate them, but they don't disappear after you've infiltrated them, so you can infiltrate them as many times as you want, which is a little bit broken, right? Right, so normally on a bridge I would either roll or walk across. But because I've triggered an alert phase, snipers are all going to be looking down their sights now, so I've kind of got to crawl really slowly. The WS under barrel. I've never really found a use for it, because they released the WS SB at the same time, and I just keep this gun here, the WS plus SB. And it's just the most OP gun. The only advantage really of the underbarrel one is you can use it with the sniper scope, so it makes like long range headshots really good. No, I never really use it. If you do an FOB and you play really badly, like I am at the minute, and you cause an alert, trick is just don't panic. Just try and stay as calm as you can.
CC,
FOBs don't really have anything to do with mother base, apart from upgrading your mother base will contribute to increasing your unit levels, and by doing that you'll be able to get better gear. Yes, the squares suit that I'm wearing at the minute is really, really good. If you get spotted on that. Two reasons, really. I don't need staff. The only staff that I actually need are S++ or S+ staff. No, everyone should have this suit. It's just called squares. Yeah, for Fultoning, I don't really need the staff, and also I don't like to troll people all that much. You know, I could go on the base and steal all their staff. But I just think it's a bit harsh. Do you want to defend against me? I'm not normally this bad, it's just that I haven't streamed for so long. I'm not used to playing at all. That I would. I've only won a handful of times against defenders. I don't think I've ever lost as a defender. It's a lot easier playing as a defender. I don't know if you guys knew as well, but if you do play against defenders and you win, you unlock different colours for your nameplates. After 10 wins you get a bronze one. I think it's 25 for silver and then 100 for gold. Shere Khan, you killed her, what, as in mission 11, you killed her at the end of that mission. If that's the case, all you do is just replay that mission and don't kill her, take her back with you. So, my rewards probably go with how well I did then, because I did terribly, so I didn't get anything above an S rank. Like I say, the only thing I'm really interested in is S plus or S plus plus. Right, I'll take requests now. Is there any particular type of FOB you guys want to see? Or any particular type of weapons you guys want to see me use? A sniper platform. Okay. Combat. Okay. Okay. I think after you've done either another one or two main missions, that should appear in your mission list to be able to replay it. And when you replay it, just don't kill her at the end, and then you'll be able to take her back to Mother Base with you. I'll just get rid of this blood. Sorry, man, I've gone in with the weapons that I had.
Successfully sneak your way into the heart of the rival PF's FOB, and you can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to
it. Right, so when you play sniper FOBs properly, not like I did it last one. What you want to do is be as quiet as possible. So, stun shotgun, which is pretty much the best weapon in the game. It will alert people to the sound of it because it makes a thud when it hits. So you're better off trying to get headshots with your tranquilizer. Obviously, if you can get through without having to shoot. So when you get on a bridge, as long as you're not in an alert phase, on a sniper, what I do is roll. If I'm on the shorter range ones, I'll walk across, but otherwise I'll roll. Just watch out for cameras like that and make sure that they're not facing you. Don't worry about the guards. They notice you like that, they won't actually spot you straight to it. Not sorry to hear that, man. You get to stay home and play Metal Gear Solid, though. Okay, so what I'm going to do with this guy that I've just got is put him behind here. That way a UAV won't notice him. You can also pick him up and throw him into the ocean if you want. That's probably the safest way to do it. But I'll just leave him there. He's already in a decent position. I can stream some MGO tonight. I only really play it when I've got my friends online, you see, and they're not on at the minute. But I can stream some tonight if you're going to be around tonight. Again, that guy's noticed me, but again, you just crawl away from it, he'll go to the spot where he noticed you. What a lot of people do is when things notice you, they tend to just stay still. That's kind of the worst thing that you can do. Like, if you look at him now, he's just going to the spot where he noticed me. And then, because I'm not there, he hasn't got a clue where I am. Just keep an ear out for UAVs. I've got one near me there, look, so I just wait for that to go past. Yo, Jason. Okay, so that's gone. No cameras to worry about, so keep rolling. You can use things like AA guns as well to hide behind. Like if there is a camera there, you can wait for it to move out of the way by hiding behind an AA gun or a container or something like that. Again, just watch out on the corners for cameras. Okay, so we're on to the main platform now. What you can do if you want is wait on the platform and just mark everything. Just helps sometimes so that you don't get spotted out of nowhere. The trickiest thing on a combat platform is the UAVs. So what you can do is you can either be really careful and try and avoid them, or you can take them out. As long as they don't make an explosion, so you shoot them out and they get taken out over the ocean, you won't cause any sort of alerts. Is there any particular advice you're after? Okay, so go around the right hand side, pretty much on every platform. Go to the right, it's just a lot easier. See, there's those guards there, which I'm going to have to watch out for as I make my way to the top. Behind this box on the left, there's going to be a camera. Just there, look. Just roll past that like so. Even if it notices you, just keep rolling. It won't spot you. The guy here. I'm just gonna hold him up.
Don't shoot.
And then if you ask him where the rest are, any nearby enemies that you haven't spotted, he'll mark for you. And there's a camera at the top of these stairs, which you just need to be careful of. On the stairs, I always make my way up to the left hand side.
Wait! Don't shoot! Why not?
Where are your friends?
Again, you just want to be as quiet as you can. As long as you don't cause any alerts. Like if you blow up a mine, then that's going to trigger some sort of alert. So I lost my perfect self at the top, and you kind of get the idea. You mean which one's easiest? Yeah, like Infrared says, base development is the easiest, although I would also say R&D is pretty easy. Just because when you're on the actual main platform, you can go around the pipes and you don't actually have to get in line of sight of any enemies. But yeah, the best depends on what you need. Most of the time you're going to need fuel, so support platform is probably the most useful. Okay, so that was a decent one for me. I got a S plus and an S plus plus out of that, so that's not bad. Unfortunately, I lost my no kill bonus and no stealth and perfect stealth bonus right at the end. Otherwise, I would have got about 20,000 infiltration points for that. But hey ho. Intel platform. Yeah, I'll do Intel next. Intel is the hardest. Yeah, I'm English. Hey, thief. I'm going to have to use my stun shotgun on the Intel platform, otherwise I won't be able to do it. Okay, so Intel platform. Intels are really good for Golden Crescent as well, by the way. A lot of people kind of run out of Golden Crescent, you know, for your tranquilizer guns and that. I mean, this is only level 45, you can get up to level 59, but this gives nearly 3,000 Golden Crescent for a successful run. I should have moved back and shot him with my stun shotgun. I didn't realise there was a mine there, which is why I grabbed him. That was just a mistake by me, that's all. Oh, when you're getting off on an FOB as well, always get off on the right side of the first platform. It just allows you to run up the stairs and run halfway across the platform before your invincibility runs out. I've used it once on a guy that had the custom cameras and mines. But everyone's now started using the new way, where you place one mine underneath the bridge. So on the little walkway underneath, three mines across the end of the bridge. So the only real way then is to climb over the side and shimmy along the right hand side of the bridge. But then they place a camera next to that side. Tell you what, after this I'll show you how people are setting it up. Is a pretty evil way of setting them up, to be honest, because then the only way that you can do it is by shimmying along the left hand side, but then of course the sniper tower is on your left, so you get spotted. It does look cool as fuck though, that jump, doesn't it?
Successfully sneak your way into the heart of the rival PF's FOB, and you can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss.
I can? Is that the one with the 9 at the end?
Be careful down there, boss!
Does it say LB9 at the end? Because if that's the case, I'm doing that later on today. Hi, mate. When you get the grade 700, I hope they don't. How far away are your unit levels to be able to get it? Another trick you can do. You shoot your tranquilizer pistol at a metal object near a guard. It'll then start investigating where the noise was. So that's an easy way to make it turn around.
Where are your friends?
Final platform on Intel. What I normally do with the Intel platforms, I'll be honest, I really, really don't like them, is I take everyone out. So the things that make the insider is tricky for me. The cameras and UAVs. If you're doing normal infiltrations, destroying the cameras and UAVs is going to open up a retaliatory wormhole. But like I said, doing security challenge, you don't have to worry about that. So what I'm going to do is just destroy all of the UAVs and cameras just to minimise my chance of getting spotted. So if you kind of wait here at the bottom of these stairs, eventually you should see them kind of floating around up above you. Just by doing this, mate, FOBs is by far and away the quickest way of doing it. So that's one UAV, there's one more somewhere. Yes, no, if you aim towards the right of a UAV, it will make it fall towards the left. So there's only going to be a maximum of one more camera. Careful coming up these stairs because sometimes there's a camera above the door. This one hasn't got that place. Just walk. Yeah, leveling up your units
infiltration successful.
It's pretty much just doing FOBs. It's the only way to get S+ and S++ stuff. Other than the FOB events as well. They're really good for doing them. Sahelanthropus on hard mode. If you get the CGM rocket launcher, which is the lock-on one, and use the hail grenade launcher, and then just have an SMG or whatever pistol you like, you should be able to destroy him quite fast. And just make sure you use your battle dress as well. Yeah, I hope that helped. I mean, it wasn't the smoothest run, but I find destroying everything on the last platform on Intel platforms to be the easiest way to do it. If you try and sneak your way through the core of it, it's really, really tricky. But if you destroy the two UAVs and the camera, it makes it a hell of a lot easier. Yeah, that's right, Ahmad. You have to save her at the end, though. Don't kill her. Yeah, just replay it 6 times, and then it changes the replay to reunion, and then you can get her back. Right, I'll quickly show you how people are setting up their custom cameras and mines. Just be one minute while I show you guys this. if you haven't already bought the custom camera and mine placement, by the way, it's well worth doing. It makes it so much harder for people to infiltrate. Because if you set it as a sniper platform and set up your cameras and your mines this way, they pretty much have to cause an alert. Not a full combat alert, but so that they go into like searching for you. And by doing that, you then have to get across three platforms while the snipers are aiming down the sights. They're always on a Tuesday, so the next one will be next Tuesday. Nice. Okay, so what people are doing is placing... camera either there or there. So basically, if you try and shimmy along here, the camera's going to spot you straight away. And then placing three mines across here. Something like that. So if you try and get through them whatever way, it's gonna blow up. So by doing that, you think, right, okay, I'll just go underneath. But then that leaves you one more mine, which you just place. That way. So as soon as one of those mines goes off, it's going to trigger an alert status, which then leaves the only real way to try and get past it is by crawling along here, but you can't do that either. Pretty evil setup. If you use that with a sniper setup, it just makes it really, really hard for the infiltrator, because they're going to blow up a mine to get past, which puts your FOB into alert status. So then all your snipers start looking down the sights, and it increases their field of vision from like 20 metres up to about 150 metres or something stupid. Any other types of FOBs you guys want to see, or you want to see me do anything in particular? Yes, they do, mate. Same with your Same with your weapons and your suits and everything. The next FOB event will be Tuesday, Thief, next Tuesday. So I'll show you support platform next. Just as well, in case you guys didn't know, anything that's in your development tree that's green, your staff can equip. So you see the things with the green titles your staff can equip. The higher level they are, the quicker they're going to kill any infiltrators. And also same with your sneaking suit and your battle dress. Like if you get grade 7 and 8 sneaking suits and battle dresses, it's going to increase them loads. To be honest with you, with defenders, it's no matter what you do, it's going to be hard. The only way that you're going to win is if the defender isn't very good. If they're even an average player, they should beat you. Because any defender worth anything is going to take a grenade launcher as their primary and just spam grenades at you, and you know, the slightest bit of splash damage that you take from those grenades is going to cause a full alert. And as soon as you go into full alert against a defender, you're screwed, because it takes at least 2 minutes to drop a full alert phase, and it only takes them 30 seconds to respawn. The amount of times that they've jammily caused an alert against me just before I've knocked them out with my S1000, I then extract them and wait by the door ready for my alert to drop, but then they respawn after 30 seconds. And every time they respawn, they get like 5 seconds of immunity as well. So the only real way to beat them is to be in a position where you don't take any damage from them. If you take the slightest bit of damage, you're not going to win. Of course, you can also just troll them. You know, if you keep killing them, eventually they'll probably leave. But again, you're going to have to be way better than the actual player to do that. That's pretty much the only way to do it. Either they get the jump on you and kill you or knock you out, and then sneak through, or they just sneak past you. As for loadouts, pretty much this is the only loadout that I ever use. You know, I'll use other things for fun. You know, sometimes take a rocket launcher or grenade launcher or something. But yeah, this is pretty much the only one that I use to play with normally. See, I've only managed that a couple of times where I've managed to sneak past them without them even knowing I was there. Okay, so I'm going to show a support platform now, because that's the one that was requested. Yeah, so the loadouts I've got, this is my main loadout that I use for pretty much everything. The S1000 is just the best gun in the game, full stop. The AM MRS-71 rifle is really, really good. You know, it's got good damage, good penetration, it's got an underbarrel, you can attach all sorts of attachments to it, it's just a really good rifle. The WU-S pistol plus SB, if you come up against people who aren't using armour, it's just stupidly overpowered. It will one-shot anybody who's not wearing body armour from any range, pretty much. And the Hand of Jehuti's stupid. It's got a range of 30 meters, so anyone within 30 meters you can pull towards you. It knocks them out of reflex mode, and then you can do whatever you want with them: hold them up, knock them over, shoot them, kill them, whatever. I then have this loadout for the schools attack event, because you're not allowed anything over grade 5 and you need a rocket launcher for it and C4. And then this is just my messing around loadout, which I always change. But yeah, this is my go-to loadout that I use for everything. You can, it's just not very powerful. That's the problem with it. Like the AM MRS-71 will critically wound grade 7 soldiers who are wearing battle dress with one shot or two shots. The 73 takes at least 3. No, I don't think I'm going to play the open beta. I played the closed beta and I wasn't all that impressed with it, to be honest. I mean, it's quite fun, but I don't think it's going to hold my attention. Kazuhira, just keep practicing, mate. That's all FOBs are, it's just knowing the route to go through and practicing. Just always go down the right-hand side of the base, because that's the easiest route. Try and stay low, don't rush. And, you know, if you fail, don't get disheartened, just try again. Eventually you'll get up to be able to do over level 40 bases. It's literally just practice. The bronze, silver and gold nameplates you have to win against defenders. 10 wins gets you bronze. I think 25 gets you silver and 100 gets you gold. I always take a lethal sniper with me so that I can shoot down UAVs or cameras if they spot me. Was this a sniper base? I can't remember if it was or not. I'll treat it as if it's a sniper base. Yeah, it is. I'm just going to kill myself.
Infiltration failed. Are you hurt? Try a little harder next time.
Yeah, you can do that. Yeah. I mean, there's no one loadout that's best. I mean, what I use is just what's best for me. I mean, if that works better for you, then it's fine. I mean, pretty much all you need for non-lethal is the Wu SB. Thief, what you can do for the nameplates if you want is, you know how you get people to support you? Get them to train on your base. And if they train on your base and shoot down some UAVs or extract some guards, it will open a retaliatory wormhole. And you can just keep using those retaliatory wormholes to farm it with each other. I haven't done that myself, but I know a couple of people who've done it. It doesn't really make a difference to what you get, but it will increase your espionage score a lot if you get no kill, no reflex. To be honest, I'm surprised they haven't made them available for MB coins. I mean, that does seem to be all that they're really bothered about at the moment. Most of the time I have a sleep grenade launcher. But if you're doing non-lethal, then a stun grenade launcher would be way better. Ah, you're playing hardcore, are you? See if I can last more than 30 seconds without causing an alert this time.
Successfully sneak your way into the heart of the rival PF's FOB, and you can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss.
To be fair, doing that will help you when you get to the higher level ones anyway. Because if you infiltrate someone who's got a 99 medical team, at least level 99, you pretty much don't get a reflex mode. Or it only lasts a split second anyway, so it'll probably take a lot more practice to be able to do it without reflex mode, you know, if you get spotted. But it will definitely help you in the long run. Buying more FOBs allows you to have more staff, and infiltrating FOBs will let you get higher level staff, so it's all about the FOBs. Yeah, I really liked the ending. A lot of people didn't, but I did really like the ending. I mean, I probably didn't like it at first, but I do really like it now. So, when you're on the main platform, on a support platform, there's pretty much two ways of doing it. Well, three ways, actually. I'll show you the way that I normally do it. Now, pretty much every other platform I go around the right, but with this one I go around the left. First thing to do is take out two snipers. Okay, so they're what I'm going to use is this staircase on the left, and if you time it right, you can get downstairs before anyone even has a chance to spot you. Just drop down here, straight down, there you go. And just watch out for the mines. And that's it. So all you really need to do is make sure you use your not to sign in to make sure nobody's going to spot you as you drop down, and that's how easy support platforms can be. Obviously, if they've got custom cameras, sometimes they'll place them on those stairs because, you know, it's impossible to avoid them, so you just need to be careful. Yeah, camouflage makes a massive... Seeing you with sweats kind of strange. Yeah, camo makes a massive difference. On FOBs, squares is the best one. Yeah, it'd be really, really good if you could do co-op on side ops. I'm surprised they didn't, because like you say, Peace Walker had it, and it was probably the best feature about Peace Walker. I mean, I really liked the main story and that, but doing side ops with people in co-op was the best bit about it. No, I've still never stolen a nuke. I'll show you why I've never stolen a nuke. Every single time. Oh, well, it's empty. But anyway, every time that someone is in there, it always comes up with a message that someone's already infiltrating it. Yeah, for some reason, squares, if you're lying down, this is if you're still, obviously, but if you're lying down, enemies won't spot you until they're within 9 meters of you. And if you're crouch walking, they won't spot you unless they're within 19 meters of you. So that's the same for cameras as well. It just makes it really, really easy. Okay, any other platforms that you guys want to see or anything like that? Yeah, if you could answer any questions that I don't spot as well, please, Infrared, because I haven't got my laptop open, so I'm only seeing the messages on the right-hand side. And, you know, when I'm playing, sometimes I miss them. I would still recommend the sneaking suit if you're not confident you can make it through without getting spotted. If there's a chance that you're going to get spotted, the sneaking suit is better because it gives you defense bonus if you've got the grade 6 and above. And it just makes it a lot easier to stay alive if they do spot you. do a non-lethal base. See if I can find one. Okay, I might fail this one. This is a non-lethal level 57 base, but I'll have a go at it. I'm going to do R&D platform just because I find R&D platforms easy. There was a guy, he doesn't do YouTube anymore, but he was called Covert, and his channel's still up, and it's worth checking out. He only did single player stuff. He didn't do any MGO or FOBs or anything, but his single player stuff was really, really good. He was that good. You know the mission, A Quiet Exit, which is probably the hardest mission in the game. It's the one with all the tanks coming at you and you've got to defend quiet. He did that with no tracers and got something like 257 or 270,000 score at the end of it. Really, really good player. And he used to do that trick where he was carrying a body all the time. Okay, right, level 57. All depends on how this guy's got his camera set up as to whether I'll be able to do this or not. But if I can make it to the last platform, I should be able to do it. It's going to have a 10-minute timer as well, so I can't afford to be spotted.
Successfully sneak your way into the heart of the rival PF's FOB, and you can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss.
Oh, he's in close 17 minutes.
Be careful down there, boss.
All units, special alert. Defend your position. Out.
Oh, bloody hell. I wasn't expecting him to have his camera there. No one puts the camera there. That means that they're online development items. Anything with a yellow background is an online development item, so the time that it takes to develop is longer, but it develops in the background regardless of whether you're online or not. And what you can also do with them is spend MB coins to shorten the development time if you really want. Pretty much all of the best weapons in the game are online.
Defend your position. Out.
you can see like how good the WU SSB against non-lethals. You don't have to aim for the head at all. In fact, it's harder aiming for the head because they have helmets. So. Oh, I'm glad my videos helped me. That's what they're there for. My espionage rank, 500 and something.
All units, special alert. Defend your position. Out.
Right, I haven't seen his custom mines yet, so he's probably going to have them in quite an awkward position on the last platform. Too many. It's over 1,000. Well, when I get to the, when I do get to the last platform, even though I'm messed up, I'll show you my routes. I find R&D platforms really easy because of the route that I do. If you get spotted like this, this is the safest spot that you can be. This last part of the bridge. Aim and click the left stick in, and then just press the direction you want to roll.
This is Zulu 2. No sign of the enemy.
Fire team, this is CP.
We have a situation. All units on alert.
Right, so on the sniper platforms anyway, if you do trigger an alert like that, they're going to stay in alert status and keep looking down their sniper sites. So it's best not to walk or roll or anything like that. Just keep crawling. If they spot you, go still and go prone and they should drop from the spot. Yeah, it's a good pistol, isn't it? This one's 57, mate.
This is Hilo 7. Direct attack. Going on alert. Over. This is CP. Understood. Check your surroundings. Out.
My route on R&D platforms, when I get off the bridge, I go right. And then down this little corridor here. And there's always a camera there, or at least on the higher level ones there is. So what I do, just make it a little bit quicker. Climb up this first pipe on the right hand side. Then climb up this one. Once you go up this one, you're pretty much at the end. Just wait here. The way I got spotted then was just my mistake. You should normally check that and just do it.
Successful.
CP, give me a sit rep. Over.
I think they're only available on PC, those rail guns that you're on about. I don't think you can get them on PlayStation 4. Regarding the amount of infiltrations I've done, I did a lot of the first school's attacks event to get the Venom Snake nameplate. I finished about 300 in the world on that. And I don't even know how many it took me. It was quite a few hundred anyway. I don't think we'll ever see Chapter 3, mate. Or if we do, it's just going to pop up as a title screen when we get the nuclear disarmament. I don't think it'll be... I don't think we'll ever get any more single-player gameplay on this. It'll just be whatever they release next. There's the next Metal Gear Solid. Any requests on Tarkov platform? Right, we got one each for combat and command. Next vote wins. Okay, one each for combat, command, and intel. First one to get to two votes wins. Two votes for Intel. What I'll do on the next one after this is I'll go for a high espionage score run. I'll use a different member of staff and do it during the day.
Successfully sneak your way into the heart of the rival PF's FOB. Capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss.
Be careful down there, boss.
Well, they're looking at doing a lot more stuff with FOBs. A guy called Chewy Don on Twitch put together a list of improvements and features that the community had like adding, and Konami have said that they're going to look at implementing the best ideas. So they'll they should hopefully add quite a few new features to FOBs sooner or later. Yeah, me too. I've got something like 500 hours. Oh, come on. As long as I don't get that's my favourite thing, not getting off that. It's the S1000 RS. It's a stun shotgun. It stuns pretty much anyone within 30 metres. Between 30 and 35 metres, it'll one shot anything.
Infiltration successful.
So, going to go for a high espionage score run now. From what I understand on Owatar, he isn't one person. It's like four or five people sharing an account. Like, apparently, if anyone ever tries to infiltrate him, he is always online 24 hours a day. So it's got to be more than one person. And I know back in the day he used to lag switch as well. I'm tempted to do this one. Try this on daytime with a lower rank soldier. Thank you. It makes it a lot harder for them to spot you during night infiltrations. Just easier doing YouTube. I've already got a subscriber base.
You can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss.
Be careful down there, boss.
I just hate how much slower the other characters are. Okay, so he's got three mines down there. He's going to have a mine down below as well.
Infiltration failed. Are you hurt? Try a little harder next time. Damn it. A staff member died. Try to be more careful next time, boss.
That's terrible. NVGs just make it so that smoke grenades don't work. Yeah, it would have been nice if I didn't get spotted before. I completely messed up then. Just a deal, you can go. You can if you put him in your combat team.
Successfully sneak your way into the heart of the rival PF's FOB, and you can capture staff from them. I'll be looking forward to meeting the new recruits, boss.
Intel's definitely the hardest.
All units, special alert. Defend your position. Out.
Thank you.
I know, I just can never be bothered to change my loadout, to be honest with you.
Successful.
Let him get the drop on you. Out.
Are you talking to me, Stephen? If so, it's that underneath my emblem, R Spencer 198420. Enforcers are ridiculous on MGO3. Completely broken. Right guys, I'm going to have to go and get something to eat because I'm starving, so I'll call an end to this stream there. Probably going to stream again later on tonight, either Street Fighter V or Metal Gear Online, so if you're about, check it out, and thanks for watching. See you later.